हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल बेस्ट ऑनलाइन मेडिकल लेक्चर्स। सो इफ यू रिमेंबर, वी हैव शेयर्ड टू वीडियोस ऑन द टॉपिक ब्लड ग्रुप्स। ओके, सो मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर ख्वाजा नवाजुद्दीन सरवरी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ए मेडिकल कॉलेज इन कर्नाटका। सो दिस टॉपिक ब्लड ग्रुप्स वी हैव डिवाइडेड इनटू 10 स्पेसिफिक लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। आउट ऑफ दैट 10 स्पेसिफिक लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस स्टार्टिंग 4 ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। जस्ट टू रिकॉल बैक, इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द हिस्ट्री, देन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द ब्लड ग्रुप्स, देन अबाउट द एग्लूटिनोजन, एग्लूटिनिन, एग्लूटिनेशन एंड लैंडस्टीनर्स लॉ। देन इन द सेकेंड वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल अबाउट द फोर्थ ऑब्जेक्टिव, दैट इज द एबीओ ब्लड ग्रुपिंग सिस्टम। ओके, सो कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सेम टॉपिक्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द अनदर 3 ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। So fifth one first, describe the RH blood grouping system. Okay, so we have discussed the ABO blood grouping system. Now today we'll discuss about the RH blood grouping system. So before coming to that, we'll just revise the thing. So if you remember, the ABO blood grouping system, it is based on the presence or absence of the antigen A or antigen B on the surface of a RBC, that is on the surface of a RBC, two important antigens, antigen A or B, will be either present. For example, if antigen A is present, it is designated as A blood group. If B is present, B blood group. If both are present, then AB blood group. If both are absent, then it is designated as O blood group. Okay, so we have already discussed that. Then apart from this A and B antigen on the surface of a RBC, there is one more important antigen known as RH antigen. So the presence or absence of this antigen, we designate the blood groups as RH positive or RH negative. So in general, what we used to say the blood group as A positive, that means A blood grouping system with RH antigen. A negative means A blood grouping system with absence of the RH negative, similarly with the other blood grouping system. Okay, so let us consider the details about this RH blood grouping system. First, about this RH antigen. Okay, so this RH antigen, it is also called as RH factor. So as this was first discovered in the RBCs of the rhesus monkey. Okay, rhesus monkey, R-H-E-S-U-S, rhesus monkey. So since it was first discovered in the rhesus monkey, that's why the term RH is used to designate this antigen, that is RH antigen. It was first discovered by Landsteiner and Wiener in the year 1940. Okay, so there are 6 types of this RH antigen known. Capital C, small c, capital D, small d, capital E and small e. So this capital D antigen, this is the RH antigen. So whenever, since it is a commonest antigen, whenever we say an RH antigen, it is represented as capital D. Okay, since it is a commonest one, and since if you remember, it is one of the major blood grouping system, and if there is an incompatibility, that is this antigen combines with its corresponding antibody, then it leads to the severe transfusion reaction. But unlike ABO blood grouping system, this antigen is not present on other tissues. If you remember, A antigen, B antigen, apart from the surface of a RBC, they are also present in other tissues like salivary glands, pancreas, amniotic fluid. Okay, but these are present only in RBCs since they are the integral membrane proteins. Okay, so let us discuss about the history, that is how this was discovered. It's RH antigen, as we said, it was discovered in 1940 by the Landsteiner and the Wiener. So they have done one experiment. So what is that experiment and how exactly this discovery of this RH antigen came into existence is, so in the year 1940, for the first time in the RBCs of a rhesus monkey, one antigen was identified. Okay, so in the rhesus monkey's RBC, on the surface of an RBC, there is an antigen, and this antigen was named as RH antigen. Okay, so what experiment they did was, so they have transfused the RBCs or the blood from the rhesus monkey to the lower animal like rabbit. Okay, so what they did was, from monkey's blood which has this RH antigen, it was transfused. Okay, so this blood which contains this RBC and this antigen was transfused into the body or the blood of the rabbit. So since the rabbit does not have this antigen, so it's a newer thing for this rabbit's immune system. So in response to that antigen, that is this D antigen, so rabbit's blood, in the rabbit's circulation, anti-D was produced. Anti-D antibody. Okay. So this is the antibody of the D antigen. So this antibodies was produced in response to this antigen. Okay. Then further, what they did was human blood. Okay. Human blood. So human RBCs or human blood was mixed. Human blood was mixed with this serum of the rabbit. So human blood was taken and it was mixed with the RBC. So interestingly, there was agglutination reaction seen. So why this agglutination reaction was seen was because human blood too contained an antigen that is similar to this RH antigen, that is this monkey's antigen. So this RH antigen, that is this antibodies, they when they are mixed, this antigen and antibody reaction takes place, that is the agglutination, and the RBCs were hemolyzed and broken down. Okay, so by this we came to know that the humans have this RBC antigen, there is a RH presence of RH antigen. Okay, and about 85% of the population generally have this RH antigen and they are designated as RH positive, and around 15% of the population does not have this RH antigen. So those persons who does not have this RH antigen, there is no agglutination with the anti-D antibody. So 15% does not have that RH antigen and they are designated as RH negative individuals. Okay. Now coming to the RH antibodies, that is this anti-D antibodies or the RH antibodies. So there are no natural antibodies like the ABO blood grouping system. If you remember, A and B antigen was the natural antigens, along with that anti-A and anti-B were the natural antibodies which were present in the human serum. Okay, but there are no natural antibodies. Normally there is no natural antibody seen in RH negative individuals in the serum of the humans. Okay, but these antibodies can be produced when the RH negative individuals are exposed to the RH positive blood. Suppose a person is an RH negative and some RH positive blood that is containing this RH antigen is infused, that is transfused. Then in response to that antigen, the immune system of that person will get sensitized, and in response to that antigen, this RH antibodies will be produced, and this RH antibodies is of IgG type. Okay, if you remember, ABO blood grouping system, AB anti-A, anti-B was IgM type. This is IgG type, and this can cross the placental barrier. Okay, and they are warm antibodies which will act best at the room temperature. Okay, so this was about the RH antibodies. Just we quickly go about the look about the population distribution of the RH positive and RH negative antigens. So in various ABO blood grouping system, as I generally said, that RH positive people, generally 85% people will have this RH antigen and around 15% doesn't have this. So if you see the O blood group, around 38.5% RH positive, 6.5% RH negative, that is O negative is 6.5%. Similarly, A positive 34% and A negative 5.7%, B positive 8.6%, B negative 1.5%, AB positive 4.3% and AB negative 0.7%. So it's clear that RH negative is relatively lesser than the RH positive. Okay, so now inheritance of the RH blood group, again it's a it is inherited as the dominant triad. So if you remember, in the ABO blood grouping system, in the ABO blood grouping system, there were six genotypes for the four blood groups. Okay, so here the genotypes are could be DD, that is homozygous dominant genes, or heterozygous, one dominant and one recessive. So RH positive individuals having the RH antigen will either have genotype of homozygous dominant or this heterozygous, one dominant one recessive gene, and RH negative individual, those who does not have the RH antigen on the surface of a RBC, their genotype small letter DD, designated as small letter DD. So if we see the inheritance pattern, suppose a father is RH positive with the homozygous dominant genotype DD and mother is an RH negative, then there are 100% chances that all the offsprings will be RH positive. Okay, because this is a recessive gene. If at all father is RH positive, phenotype is RH positive, but the genotype is DD, that is one smaller D, that is it is a recessive gene. So still then there is a 50% chances of having a children of Rh positive and 50% as Rh negative. Okay. So that was about the Rh blood grouping system, about the Rh antigen and the Rh antibody. So if after knowing that, quickly moving to the next objective, describe the Rh incompatibility or the hemolytic disease of the newborn or erythroblastosis fetalis. So at this point I would like to tell that this topic is very important clinically as well as from the exam point of view of the MBBS students who are appearing for the first MBBS physiology exam. So this questions has been asked several times, either as a main long essay for 10 marks or as a short notes for five marks. Okay, they have asked several times, and clinically it is also very important to know this concept of erythroblastosis fetalis or the Rh incompatibility, and we can prevent and treat this particular condition. Okay, so let us discuss what exactly this means. Okay, so this is also known as hemolytic disease of the newborn, erythroblastosis fetalis, Rh incompatibility. All means one and same. Okay, now what does this erythroblastosis fetalis or that other hemolytic disease of the newborn means? So it is basically incompatibility of the Rh blood groups between the fetus and the mother. So what does it means? Okay, suppose or consider a pregnant lady. Okay, pregnant lady. So pregnant lady and the baby which is present in the womb of a mother, that is in the uterus of a mother. Okay, so if there is incompatibility means mismatching, that is pregnant lady might be Rh negative and the baby inside the womb of the mother may be Rh positive. So when there is this Rh positive and Rh negative blood of the mother mixes, then there is a severe transfusion reaction takes place, and that is called as erythroblastosis fetalis. So how this transfusion reaction takes place, or this how this condition of hemolytic disease of the newborn develops, we will see this in the mechanism. So please concentrate, this is a very important topic. So consider a woman, okay, consider a woman or the mother who is Rh negative, that is in the blood of the mother there is no Rh antigen, that is she is Rh negative. It could be A negative, B negative, AB negative or O negative, any of the ABO blood grouping system with Rh negative, and father as Rh positive. Okay, any ABO blood grouping system, but factor is Rh is positive. Okay, now when they conceive and in the first pregnancy, suppose the baby or the child or the fetus which is present in this womb of a Rh negative mother, it happens to develop as a Rh positive. Okay, the fetus blood group is Rh positive because it might have inherited the positive Rh positive antigens or the positive genes from the father. Okay, so when the baby inherits the positive factor from the father, then the baby's blood group is Rh positive. Okay, so what happens in the first pregnancy? So some amount of the antigens, that is this Rh positive means some Rh antigens which are present on the RBCs of this fetus, will try to enter or just enters the maternal blood, but there is no significant reaction takes place because the amount will be very much little. Okay, so nothing will happen during the first pregnancy, but at the time of the delivery of the same first pregnancy, so what happens is when there is a delivery, that is at the end of the ninth month, okay, at the end of the ninth month when the delivery has taken place, so when the baby is born, there due to the severance of the umbilical cord, severance means cutting of the umbilical cord, so when there is a severance of the umbilical cord, there is a mixing of the fetal blood with the maternal blood or the mother's blood. So at that time, that is during the time of delivery, what will happen is this Rh antigen blood, the blood of the fetus which contains the Rh antigen, gets transfused or entered into the maternal blood circulation. Okay, but the baby which was born as a Rh positive, nothing will happen. So first pregnancy will be uneventful and the baby will be born healthy, there will be no immune reaction. Okay, now what happens during the subsequent pregnancy? So once this Rh antigen enters this Rh negative mother, so this Rh antigen is a new thing for a mother circulation, so it gets sensitized, that is the mother's immune system gets sensitized with that antigen, and in response to that antigen the mother produces the Rh antibodies, that is this anti-D antibodies against this Rh antigen. Okay, so in this diagram, this green color square, what we are seeing, it is depicted as Rh antibodies. Okay, so the mother forms the Rh antibodies in her circulation against these antigens. Now इफ दी अगेन द मदर कंसीव्स इन द सेकेंड प्रेगनेंसी, ओके, इन द सेकेंड प्रेगनेंसी सेकेंड टाइम, एंड अगेन द बेबी has inherited the RH factor from the father and the baby or the fetus is RH positive, then in the second pregnancy, these RH antibodies which are already present in the maternal circulation will cross the placenta and enters to the fetal circulation, okay, because RH antibodies are IgG type, okay, so that's why we don't see incompatibility of the ABO blood grouping system, okay, because it's our IgM time, it does not process the placental barrier, these are IgG type, okay, remember, so that's why they can cross this placental barrier and enters the maternal circulation, and once this antibodies enters the maternal circulation, then it will combine with that antigens of the RBCs of the baby, and when this antibody and antigens are combined, it leads to the agglutination reaction. Due to that agglutination reaction or the clumping, the RBCs are broken down and it leads to the hemolysis. That's why the disease name is hemolytic disease of the newborn. Okay, that's why it is termed as hemolytic disease of the newborn. Okay, so now, what are the clinical features if at all this condition develops? So what will be the clinical presentation of that hemolytic disease of newborn or erythroblastosis fetalis? So around 2% of the second RH positive pregnancy shows the erythroblastosis, and 10% of the third babies exhibit this disease. So this incidence will increase in the subsequent pregnancies because more number of the antibodies will get developed in the mother circulation, and the subsequent pregnancies it will be of more severity. So what are the signs and symptoms seen in this clinical condition of hemolytic disease of newborn or erythroblastosis fetalis? So as the name indicates, erythroblastosis, so in the blood of the fetus, more number or the large number of the erythroblasts are seen. So in the peripheral blood sample, if we see, there are immature erythroblast cells. Erythroblast cells are the larger in size as compared to the normal RBCs, and they are nucleated cells, that is immature cells. So why means? Because there is a more breakdown of the RBCs, and baby's hemopoietic tissues try to produce more RBCs. So in this process, more number of the immature cells will appear in the blood. Okay, then it is the same thing. You can see this nucleated erythroblast, and you can compare this with the normal RBCs. Okay, so more. So that's why this term, disease is termed as erythroblastosis. Okay, then apart from that, severe anemia is seen. Why anemia is seen? Because of the excessive breakdown of the, due to the agglutination reaction, RBCs will get broken down and the hemoglobin is liberated, and that's why there is a decrease in the hemoglobin, and anemia, severe anemia is seen. Okay, then due to the breakdown of that RBCs and due to the metabolism of that hemoglobin, the hemoglobin gets converted into bilirubin, and clinically jaundice is seen. And this jaundice in that infant or the newborn, it's known as icterus gravis neonatorum. So one of the commonest cause of jaundice in the first day. Okay, generally the first day, the jaundice appearing on the first 24th hours after the pregnancy, considered as a pathological jaundice. Okay, if a baby is developing jaundice within the first 24 hours, it's always a pathological condition. One of the causes this hemolytic disease of the newborn, and the liver and spleen will get enlarged because this tissue, these organs try to produces the more amount of the RBCs. Okay, RBCs, that's why, because there is a deficiency, they tend to produce, and in that process the size of that particular tissues will get enlarged. Then finally, actually anemia is so severe that there are so many deaths have taken place because of the severe anemia. The babies who survive this severe kind of anemia, then there one more serious condition known as kernicterus is seen. So what exactly this kernicterus means? There is a mental impairment and change in the motor areas of the brain. Why it takes place is this bilirubin crosses the blood brain barrier and precipitates the neuronal cells, and they destroy the neuronal cells and damages the brain tissue. Okay, so because of that entry of the bilirubin to the brain and the damage to the neuronal cells, this terminology is known as kernicterus. Okay, then You can see this diagrammatic representation of jaundice and carnic tress here. So jaundice, the baby shows the yellowish discoloration of this full skin or the mucous membrane, and when it's goes to the brain, then it leads to mental impairment on the motor areas get damaged, that is carnic tress. Then one more complication we see is hydrops fetalis, that is the fetus may develop the edema of all the organs leading to the intrauterine death. Okay, so sometimes this develops inside only before the delivery, and the intrauterine death is seen. As you can see, there is enlargement of all the organs like swollen liver and the severe abdominal swelling. Okay, this condition is known as hydrops fetalis. Then we can prevent this disease. Okay, how we can prevent this disease? If we come to know the RH blood group beforehand itself, okay, if we come to know that the lady or the mother is RH negative and the father is RH positive, then we can try to prevent this condition of hemolytic disease of newborn erythroblastosis fetalis. How can we prevent it? By injecting this RHD or anti-D antibodies or RH immunoglobulin to the mother. So RHD antibodies or immunoglobulin to the mother is injected around 28 to 30 weeks of the gestation and immediately after the first delivery, that is within the 72 hours. So as we have discussed in the mechanism of development of erythroblastosis fetalis, so during the time of delivery the blood from the fetal circulation enters into the maternal circulation. So if we inject immediately after delivery, that is within 72 hours after the delivery, this RH antibody in the form of RH immunoglobulin. So already the immunoglobulin will be present in the maternal blood. So the RH antigens which are entering from the baby get mixed up with that RH antibody which are artificially infused by or injected. Then it will neutralizes that antigens, and these antigens will not stimulate the immune system of the mother to produce RH antibodies. Okay, so that's why we can prevent it, for prevent the development of the RH antibodies in the mother for the next pregnancy. Okay, then if at all this condition has developed, how to manage this condition? So for management, the best thing is doing the exchange transfusion. Now what is this exchange transfusion? So in this exchange transfusion, there is a replacement of the RH positive blood in infant by the RH negative blood. So what actually it is done is around 400 ml of the blood is removed from the baby, and simultaneously around 400 ml of the RH negative, baby's RH positive blood is removed, and RH negative blood, same compatible RH negative blood is injected. Okay, simultaneously. So this process is taken place around in 1.5 hours, and this exchange transfusion is repeated many a times during the first few weeks of life. So while doing this, what will happen is the baby's blood ultimately will become RH negative, that is RH blood is RH positive blood is replaced by the RH negative blood. So when the baby's blood is RH negative, then the antibodies which are entered through the maternal circulation, so these antibodies will not react with the antigens since the baby's blood has become RH positive negative. So there will be no chances of developing of the carnic tress or there is hemolysis or bilirubin release. Okay, so that's the basis. So it's again a diagrammatic representation of the exchange transfusion, how it is done. Okay, so 400 ml of the blood is transfused, and simultaneously the 400 ml of the blood is removed. Okay, now we have completed two important objectives today about the RH blood grouping system and the RH incompatibility. Okay, now the video length is increasing, I am aware of that. Just quickly I'll finish it off with this last objective in this video, and we'll complete the remaining objectives of blood transfusion, blood bank in the next video, that is the video number 4 of the blood group, that is the part 4th. Okay, so we'll discuss just quickly within 4 to 5 minutes, discuss the clinical importance of the blood groups. Okay, so what is the use of doing the blood typing to know our blood group? Okay, whatever blood group I may be having, either A positive, O negative, whatever. So what is the use of doing this or knowing your blood grouping? So this uses, clinical use of blood group, again this could be a 5-mark short answer to you people in theory exams. Okay, in theory exams of first MBBS physiology, what are the uses of blood groups? So first and foremost thing is, it is very much helpful to know the compatible blood group for blood transfusion. Blood transfusion means blood donation. When during the blood donation you give the blood Okay, we'll discuss in detail about the blood transfusion in our next objective. So I won't discuss much now. Just remember, it is most useful in blood transfusion. Next objective, we'll discuss in detail about this blood transfusion, how it is done and all. Okay, then prevention of the hemolytic disease of the newborn. So this blood grouping is also helpful. We have already discussed in today's objective itself, that is to prevent this disease. If we come to know beforehand only that mother is Rh negative and the father is Rh positive, then most likely they may develop this hemolytic disease of newborn. Then we can prophylactically give the mother this anti-D or the Rh immunoglobulin, okay, to prevent this disease. So prevention, already we have discussed. Then the in certain medico-legal issues, okay, in certain medico-legal issues also this general blood grouping is helpful. So how it is helpful? Suppose if there is a site of a crime, okay, site of a crime, and there is a victim, then there are certain blood stains at the site of the crime on the clothes or the other substances. If that blood typing is done and the victim blood typing is done, and then we can match, okay, some there can be link a probability that blood is of that particular victim or accused, whatever, okay. So in medical legal issues also this is helpful. Then again, one of the most important use is in paternity disputes. So what exactly this paternity disputes are? So many a times the disputes arises. So a father may say that a particular child does not belongs to me, that is, that child is I am not the biological father of a particular child. So with the help of the blood groups, we can try to find out the reality, but it has certain limitations. Okay, I'll give some example. For example, if a child blood group is O, so the child blood group is O, you know that the genotypes will be O and O, that is, one gene of the O has to be transferred from the father and the one gene of the O has to be transferred from the mother. Okay, so now suppose whatever the blood group of the mother could be either A, B or O, so in this condition, in this particular condition or the dispute where father is denying that this child does not belongs to me, so if the father's blood group, okay, if the father's blood group is AB, okay, so the father's blood group of AB means genotypes will be A on one gene and B on the another gene, okay, so we can say that in this condition that this child does not belongs to this particular father. How? Because the child has to inherit one gene of blood group from the father and from the mother. So since the father has the A and B gene, so there is no scope of the child having here O blood grouping system. Okay, so in this way this will help in paternity disputes. One more example I will give you. Suppose again, similarly, the child is having a blood group AB again, so then the child's phenotype is AB, that is, blood grouping is AB, then child should inherit one gene of A from the father or mother, or one gene of B from father or mother. So again, this whatever could be the blood group of mother, the father's blood group here, the father's blood group here can't be blood group O. Can't be blood group O. So because this blood group, again, genotypes will be O and O, so you can say that this particular child does not belongs to this father, or this father is not a biological father of this particular child. So similarly, it will help in other blood grouping system also in solving this paternity disputes. Then finally, knowing susceptibility to certain diseases, still it's under research, that is, some diseases are more common in a particular blood group. For example, peptic ulcer disease is seen in O blood group more commonly, or carcinoma of stomach or the cancer of the stomach or pancreas is seen more commonly in the blood group A. Okay, some research papers have proved that, but still we have to evaluate this thing still more. Okay, so these are the clinical uses of the blood group. Okay, now this is the end of our video. Finally, before concluding, we'll just discuss within 1 minute about the Bombay blood group. This is one of the rare blood group which we have discussed earlier. So this Bombay blood group was first discovered in the year 1952, okay, by Dr. Y.M. Bhinde, 1952, in the city Bombay in India. Okay, at that time the name of the city was Bombay, now it is known as Mumbai. So what is this specialty of this particular disease or blood group is, this is a very rare blood group, 1 in million. Okay, so basically if you remember, we have discussed in the ABO blood grouping system, on the surface of a RBC is there will be presence of the H gene, okay, H gene or H antigen. So this H gene or H antigen will become either A antigen or B antigen, okay, but in this blood group, that is Bombay blood group, there is absence of H gene, okay, there is no H gene present. So generally all individuals will have H gene on the surface of a RBC, but in this Bombay blood groups there is absence of this H gene. So since there is H gene is absent, then A or B antigen or the H antigen is absent, A antigen or the B antigen is not developed. So basically here H antigen is absent, okay, H antigen is absent, and the A and B antigens are not developed. So on the surface of the RBC there will be no antigens, whereas in the plasma of blood grouping system they will have the antibodies, natural antibodies of anti-A, anti-B and anti-H antibodies. So as a result of this, so these person can't receive blood from other ABO blood group system, they have to be get transfused by only Bombay blood group system. Why? Means they have this antibodies, okay, they don't have the H antigens, they don't have the H antigen, okay, I was saying H gene but it is H antigen, they don't have the H antigen on the surface of RBC, but they have the antibodies. So if the other blood groups which have the other antigens and they react with this antibodies, there is agglutination reaction and it will lead to hemolysis, okay, and severe transfusion reactions can take place, okay. So this is all in this part 3 of blood groups. So we'll continue in the part 4, the remaining topics or remaining objectives of the blood transfusion, blood banking, and how we will store the blood in the blood bank. So till that, take care and please subscribe and like our videos and do share it. Thank you.